Run, little rivulet, run. Summer is fairly begun. Bear to the meadow the hymn of the pines and the echo that rings where the waterfall shines. Run, little rivulet, run. Run, little rivulet, run. Sing of the flowers, every one, of the delicate harebell and the violet blue, of the red mountain rosebud all dripping with dew. Run, little rivulet, run. Run, little rivulet, run. Stay not till summer is done. Carry the city, the mountain bird's glee. Carry the joys of the hills to the sea. Run, little rivulet, run. Mni Wichoni. Translated, it means water is life. Indigenous peoples around the globe have long understood the importance of water and how it must be used effectively and sustainably. From the deserts to the oceans, Indigenous communities have a deep knowledge of how the cycles of water are interconnected with the cycles of life. And we're gonna talk all about those interconnections today, here on Indigi-Genius.
Cut. Water.
Oh, please, thank you. It's very water. Oh, thank you. Oh. For many Indigenous people, water is life, and water is sacred. Since almost 60% of the human body is made up of water, and water makes up over 70% of the world itself, water plays an important part in many cultural practices. It is also related to Indigenous identities and origin stories. For the Diné, there is the hero born for water, and the clans that include Big Water, Near the Water, and many other water-based clans. The use and practice of taking care of water is woven with an inherent respect for water as a living being that gives life and supports health. This understanding of the connections of traditional values, sustainability, and resource management is key to Indigenous life around the globe. This understanding begins with freshwater collection. Although the methods for collection and sustainability have been labeled as primitive, they are the foundations for all our water systems to this very day. Water ponds and aquifers, efficient sanitation and farming, and recycling methods all have their roots in Indigenous water management systems. As many of us learned in elementary school, there are three stages of water cycles: evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. As the planet is made up on mostly salt water, this water cycle is the only way life develops on land from freshwater consumption. After collecting the fresh water, Indigenous peoples would use many methods to purify and maintain the water system. This included boiling and filtering the water. For example, the Mayan people filtered through a mixture of zeolite and coarse, sand-sized crystalline quartz. Zeolite is a non-toxic, three-dimensionally porous crystalline, hydrated aluminosilicate with natural absorbent and ion exchange properties, which removes harmful microbes as well as disperses insoluble and soluble toxins from drinking water. From ancient waffle gardens, acequias, cisterns, snowmelt, and irrigation lines, to modern-day underground plumbing, rain barrels, aqueducts, diversion channels, and water catches of all shapes and sizes, Indigenous understandings and methods of sustainability echo throughout the millennia. For Indigenous water management systems, careful considerations continue to be made in balancing cultural and spiritual elements with the biological need for fresh water, which can be especially important for peoples where fresh water is scarce. These considerations highlight how Indigenous peoples have been water management experts for thousands of years. When I was little, my father and I planted little corn seeds in clay pots beside our apartment window. It was part of a grad study that he had to do, and he wanted me to join in with him on that. I marveled at how delicate these little seeds were and how little water it took them to sprout. It was my first understanding of the importance of water and how it contributes to these cycles of life. If we consider that only 3% of the water on this earth is fresh water that is used to sustain life, it becomes even more critical that we have a deep understanding of how to sustain that water for all of us that are living. And these understandings come from a deep Indigenous knowledge. And that knowledge is on display each and every day here on Indigi-Genius. Mni Wichoni.